Water pressure means divers are only able to go a few dozen meters underwater and only for a limited periods of time. But now researchers can explore or carry out tasks at depths of hundreds or even thousands of meters, thanks to the latest underwater robots.
In the subsea oil and gas market, there are fields that are deployed in the Gulf and elsewhere around the world that need maintenance, and typically that's done in deep water with ROVs. It's just an old way of doing things, and we think that we can basically bring the latest technology to that problem to reduce costs and also reduce risk. I'm Sandeep Yayathi, I'm the chief engineer on the Aquanaut project. We built a transformer. So this transforming vehicle allows us to have a hydrodynamic shape that we can actually transit to a worksite and then get there and deploy manipulator arms to then go do a task that a traditional ROV would do. This is where pretty much all of the buildup for Aquanaut is happening. We're a very vertically integrated company, do the electrical design, mechanical design, software, and buildup all here. This is Aquanaut's manipulator arm. It's got 8 degrees of freedom. It can go down into the depths of the ocean and turn valves, operate torque tools.
Well, this is Aquanaut's machine vision system. So there's several ways that Aquanaut perceives the world. Inside of here, we have two machine vision cameras. And we also have a 3D structured light sensor. This will allow Aquanaut to see the world, and then Aquanaut will process that data and send us back a subset, which allows us to see the world Aquanaut's in.
This is Cybertron. This is sort of the belly of the beast, if you will. It's got all the smarts, the power electronics, all that stuff.
We're from Cybertron.
Everything on board the vehicle is Transformers reference. Everything.
You'll notice Energon over here. These are our batteries providing the energy to the vehicle. But yeah, we try to live that Transformers life.
It's a super inclusive group. They do their own thing. They don't like other people. It's really terrible.
At least 30% of the connectors are serial power connections. In this space, we are definitely the underdog. We came onto the scene with a bunch of scrappy ex-NASA engineers to start. We're basically taking experience from another industry and applying it to the subsea space. We have a unique advantage where most companies don't have a team of people that have put, you know, things in space. In robotics, you've got multiple components that all have to come together. So it's a big systems engineering problem. You've got to be able to build boards that compile various technologies together in a form factor that will fit and, you know, meld with all our mechanical structures. So you need good software, you need good electromechanical hardware. We've found innovative ways to use our mechanical CAD tools. We've also found innovative ways to use Altium Designer to do things it's not really supposed to be designed to do. We use it to track all of our vehicle cabling management, which would be done traditionally another way, but we managed to massage it, come up with our own rules of how we could implement version tracking of the vehicle's physical connections, and then translate that out into like web pages and documentation that we use for our ops team to use in the field. You know, just gotta be scrappy and innovative. Yeah, we're hoping to get the vehicle all put together, and we're going to be out at the neutral buoyancy lab at NASA testing in December again. I think we're going to make it. Yeah, hell or high water, we'll be in the pool, and this thing will be in test.
Listen, I'm just glad they recorded that, because now it has to happen.
What's coming up in a few weeks is basically we're going to go and take all these new add-ons, new upgrades that we've implemented, new releases of code and software, and we want to shake it out. So we're going to take it to the NBL. It's a nice safe environment. It's a huge pool. It's an amazing facility where the astronauts actually train on a copy of the space station, which is buried in the pool. So massive body of water.
Let's just start it over.
Copy the program?
No, it's fine.
Copy.
Here we go.
Ops, this is safety. We're ready to begin the calibration.
You can go ahead and push off.
Copy.
Okay, safety. I'm enabling thrusters. 3, 2.
Copy.
Safety, this is Ops. I am going to transform. Open.
Copy.
This particular trip, we're here to advance some of our perception capabilities and manipulation capabilities. One of the ways we've done that is we've actually sent our dive team in where we could install a bunch of these vision targets in the pool. We're also going in and manipulating tools that we place at the bottom of the pool to practice having Aquanaut actually grab tools and insert them into things and so forth. There are a lot of tasks that are very easy for us to do, but we have some pretty high power computing capability. Teaching a robot to do those same types of things is actually very difficult.
All right, Grabby, do your thing.
Oh, wow. Nice.
Oh, okay. Ooh. Now, if you just open Grabby and then move forward.
We know we're not here anymore. We kind of backed away, so.
As a human being, you think, there's an apple on the table, I know how to grab an apple, I'm gonna put my hand like this, I'm just gonna grab the apple. But the robot has to look at that, decide it's an apple, decide it's soft or hard, or...
Just go for it. Just go for it.
World's most expensive claw game.
You don't even get like a fuzzy bear on the prize.
Don't knock it over.
Don't break this up.
Isn't he not supposed to know?
All right,
blend. All right, nice. Passed her first day of ROV operator school. Getting to that moment where you work really hard, you put something together that the world and other people can appreciate and will add some value back in society. And like, you did this with a team. Getting to that moment where all that stuff comes together, like those are the things that I strive towards. That's what sort of drives me. Now do it 100 more times. All right.
Thank you for watching Altium Stories. If you enjoyed what you've seen, please give us a like and share the video, and don't forget to subscribe. We'd love to hear what you think, so please leave a comment in the section below.